Some of the ulama, rahimahumullah, mentioned that the word subhanallah, in all of its forms, there is about 92 of them mentioned in the Quran. And the word as-sujood, or sajada, or sajidun, in all of its forms is also found 92 times in the Quran. Yani, in other words, at-tasbih is just as important as as-sujood. Then it was given the same number and the same mention in the Quran. Can you imagine 92 times each mentioned in the Quran? In other words, your sujood is just as important as the tasbih. At-tasbih, my brothers in Islam, some of its benefits and outcomes. In Surah As-Sajda, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, خَرُّوا سُجَّدًا وَسَبَّحُوا بِحَمْدِ رَبِّهِمْ وَهُمْ لَا يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ فَيَعْنِي The one that makes a proper sujood and he begins to glorify Allah in his sujood, سُبْحَانَ رَبِّيَ الْأَعْلَى. This التسبيح is supposed to result in a person وَهُمْ لَا يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ That al-kibr or the arrogance is supposed to be demolished and destroyed in a person, right? التسبيح also يعني is a reason for why dua is accepted. Musa alayhi salam, he makes the dua, كَيْ نُسَبِّحَكَ كَثِيرًا وَنَذْكُرَكَ كَثِيرًا إِنَّكَ كُنْتَ بِنَا بَصِيرًا. What was the conclusion? قَدْ أُوتِيتَ سُؤْلَكَ يَا مُوسَى. يعني once he mentioned التسبيح, eventually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Musa alayhi salam, before he moved from the mountain, he was given what he wanted. Tasbih is a reason for why dua is accepted, right? فَأَنْتَ يعني your dua must begin with تسبيح الله subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it must end with تسبيح الله subhanahu wa ta'ala. يعني بإذن الله, a person is guaranteed that his dua is accepted. التسبيح, it is the secret for forgiveness. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم in a hadith, he says, he came to his sahaba and he asked them, يعني is any one of you unable to gather 1,000 hasanat in the day or remove and wash away from himself 1,000 sayyat? Is anyone unable to do that? For they said, يعني what is that, Ya Rasulullah? What do we do so that we achieve this huge reward? For Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said to them, Subhanallah, 100 times would earn a person 1,000 hasanat, and يعني in the same narration, or wipe away from the person 1,000 sayyat, depending on what intention he said it. If he said it in the intention of increasing hasanat, then it gives him 1,000 hasanat. Says it in the intention of cleansing and purifying himself, it would wipe away from his account 1,000 sayyat. This is the hadith that says, if you say subhanallah 100 times. There's another hadith. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, man qala subhanallahi wa bihamdi. You add the word wa bihamdi. That if you were to say subhanallah and add to it the word wa bihamdi, this is going to teach you how powerful the hamd is. Subhanallah, you add to it wa bihamdi 100 times a day, it wipes away the person's sins, even if they were to amount the foam of the ocean. Yani, in other words, now endless, unlimited number of sayyat would be wiped away from a person's record just by adding the word wa bihamdi to the word subhanallah. At-tasbih, my brothers in Islam, is also the secret of salvation. Being protected and saved in life from calamities and disasters, you'll find that in at-tasbih. That you know how to free yourself from the worries and the troubles of the life through at-tasbih. Try it. It works. Allah Azza wa Jal gives us the story of Yunus alayhi salam. And he says about Yunus, فَلَوْلَا أَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ. If Yunus alayhi salam hadn't been from those who make tasbih, كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ. Well, the word musabbihin also implies that he was consistent upon the tasbih and the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what would have happened if Yunus alayhi salam wasn't of those who made tasbih of Allah much? Allah Azza wa Jalla, he said, لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. He would have remained in the belly of the whale until the day of judgment. One word saved him. The word subhanallah in his life, because he had plenty of it in his life, in the moment of disaster and trial and tribulation. So the first thing, as he was in the belly of the whale, very famous dua, and he said, La ilaha illa ant, subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. Three parts. La ilaha illa ant, there is no Lord worthy of worship except you. Subhanaka, yani he's declaring Allah Azza wa Jalla's perfection. And then after this, إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. He acknowledged that he was the one that oppressed himself. Salvation, this is what saved him. As a result, Allah Azza wa Jal converted his problem into a solution.